I'm Adrian from AWS.
And I'm Angus from Swyftx, and this is My Architecture.
So today we're going to talk about all things crypto. And Angus, you run one of the biggest digital currency exchanges. What's it like to be in your world?
Yeah, it's very fast paced. So Swyftx has 700,000 customers, and we need to be able to have a auditable and secure and a testable pipeline to be able to push engineers' code into production.
Well, I know you've done a lot of work in that space, so let's dive in.
So we kick it off with Control Tower. So the reason for Control Tower is on the board here, we've got four AWS accounts. In actual fact, we've got 14 currently, and that's yet to grow, of course. Control Tower allows us to be able to automatically provision and manage all of these environments in a consistent manner.
So why did you spend so much time thinking about your account structure?
Yeah, so Swyftx manages multiple billions of customer funds, and so security is at the top of our list for our priorities. Mm-hmm. And so that means we need to invest in this kind of structure.
Got it. All right, so how do your engineers get going?
Yeah, so they've obviously got their laptops and they're pushing code to GitHub. There's a couple of pre-checks involved there, but soon on they'll make a PR, and that PR will kick off a pipeline run by Tekon within our Amazon EKS cluster.
So I see you've used EKS and the Kubernetes ecosystem. You could have used lots of other different container services. Why did you choose that?
Yeah, so EKS gives us the best of both worlds. So we've got the managed service control plane aspect of it, but we also get to bring in all of these open source tools, which I'll talk to shortly, to be able to get our secure pipeline operating as we need it to.
Got it.
So kicking on, Tekon kicks off a build of our images. It'll pull in some configuration and then also run tests and security checks on it.
So you've got containers, obviously, for all of these different open source and third-party services. So obviously managing and keeping those up to date is nice and easy. What are you using ECR for?
We use ECR. Once we've built this image, we can push it to our ECR registry within our CI/CD account. From there, we've got a signed image, which we can then choose to promote as we want to.
And I imagine you have to keep different versions as well, right?
Yeah, we all need that history kept for sure. In order to promote it, we use IAM roles, and we will push the ECR image from our CI/CD account into our Playground account.
Right. So I see you're actually using a lot of the native integrations, not just of the Kubernetes ecosystem, but also the AWS ecosystem as well.
Exactly, yeah.
Right. So once your engineers are in the playground, why have we got these different EKS clusters?
Yeah, so we've got a bunch of different workloads that we need to do within the playground environment. We've got a couple of ephemeral environments down here. And so what these are is just running on the feature branch that engineers working on, so the upcoming feature release. We've also got some of these other ones, which will keep the latest running on there, and that will allow our product managers or stakeholders to be able to review in-flight work.
Gotcha. Okay, so after that, how does it actually get promoted to production?
Engineers, we've got two reviews on that PR, and once that's approved, it'll kick off a CI/CD workflow again. But this time, it'll go through all the same checks, a lot more stringent though this time, and create that image in ECR. Finally, again, using IAM roles, we will push these images into either the development initially, and then later on, once it passes the test in there, into our production environment.
So with all this automation, no one person owns and controls everything, right?
Exactly. All there is the approval steps to get it either code merged in or to be able to deploy to production.
Yeah, that's awesome. Now, I do see Amazon security like there. Tell us how you're using that.
Yeah, so I talked earlier about our 14 accounts, and as I said, that's going to grow. Security Lake allows us to be able to pull in logs from all of these different environments and manage them all in one place. So that wraps up GuardView, that wraps up VPC flow logs, and allows us to see that in a centralized location within our security account.
So not only does it aggregate all these different services for you, but makes it really easy to operate, right?
Exactly. It's a constant workload. There's no increased cost for extra accounts, but we do get the extra value of having segregated works.
So I love all the work that you've put in here in the automation. And I think it's something a lot of other companies can certainly learn from. Thanks, Angus, for joining me today.